What's up guys, you're watching In Our Today Tech. I'm Rahul Sethi, and in this video we're going to talk about a very beautiful looking smartphone, the Oppo R17. It has a very beautiful looking design and comes with variable aperture cameras similar to what we saw on the Galaxy S9 and in the S9 Plus. But does the smartphone justify its heavy price tag of 45,000 rupees? Let's take a look. The Oppo R17 has an amazing looking design. It comes with a metal body with glass back, but the glass back has a very matte-like finish, so from afar it doesn't look like it has glass at the back. It does attract smudges and fingerprints, but they are not very visible on this smartphone, a problem with most of the glass back phones. But it has a very beautiful looking color. It reflects light in a very nice way, and you'll see as you rotate the smartphone, it shows the hues of blue, violet, indigo and purple, all in a very subtle manner. The phone has curved edges and rounded corners, so you'll see it is very comfortable to hold and use in the hands. The buttons are very tactile, and at the bottom you'll see it has a single tray that can take two SIM cards. There's a Type-C USB port, microphone and speaker grill at the bottom, and at the top you get the secondary microphone for noise cancellation. The camera unit is slightly extending out of the body, and you'll see though the phone has three cameras, the time of flight sensor is not usable right now. Oppo will push an upgrade that will activate this camera, and using this, Oppo says you'll be able to capture world around you in 3D, and it will also be used for augmented reality based applications. Now the Oppo R17 has amazing cameras. I mean, it comes with variable aperture, so the aperture shifts from f1.5 to f2.4 while you're clicking photos in various light situations. I mean, good light situations, you'll see Oppo R17 does a great job. It captures amazing colors. The photos have good brightness, details and contrast. A fast shutter speed also helps in reducing shake. So most of the photos we took from the phone were really crisp. There's artificial intelligence based scene recognition that is able to detect a scene and automatically adjust the settings for the best shot. But low light performance on Oppo R17 is also quite stunning. The camera automatically switches to a wider f1.5 aperture to take more light, so photos look brighter. This combined with optical image stabilization will make sure that you get no blurred photos. In some situations like this that has extreme low light, the R17 did a remarkable job. There is very little noise, and you'll see quite a lot of details are captured by the camera. At the front, the phone has a 25 megapixel selfie shooter with f2.0 aperture. In good light situations, it offers good details and sharp selfies. Beauty mode is enabled by default, so you'll notice some over smoothening, but things will become more true to life once you disable the beautification mode. There's also a selfie portrait mode that uses software to blur the background, and it does a decent job. Since it runs Oppo's Color OS and has a drop style notch, it reminds us of the Realme 2 Pro, which is a much cheaper smartphone. The notch has just the camera, while the earpiece is placed between the display and the body. The fingerprint scanner is placed below the display and is quite fast, but you'll feel a little slowness if you're used to a regular fingerprint scanner that uses a capacitive sensor. The phone also has face recognition, which is also amazingly fast, but again it's not IR based and may not be as secure as what you get on phones like Vivo V11 Pro or the iPhone XR. Now we also like the display on the smartphone. It is very bright and the viewing angles on it are amazing. The color reproduction, as you can see, is also very nice. The hue and saturation of the screen is nicely balanced, and you get a very nice watching experience. Thanks to almost no bezels, you feel like holding the screen while watching videos, and it's quite a delightful experience. The viewing angles on this IPS panel is also very amazing. Like most flagship smartphones in this segment, this phone also has a very smooth touchscreen paired with the display. So while playing games like PUBG, we experienced a very smooth gameplay, and the finger just glides on the screen. Thanks to no touch response lag, we were able to play PUBG quite well on this device. Although the chipset used on it is Snapdragon 710, which is nowhere close to Snapdragon 845 used on the OnePlus 60, you still get good gaming experience. We were able to play PUBG in medium graphic settings, which was quite smooth, but you cannot push it to high settings as you can do on the Snapdragon 845. And that is where the hardware drawback comes in. I mean, at this price point, there are many smartphones that offer you top-end chipset. Also, the Color OS, though is fast and smooth, is not as amazing as the stock Android, and we'll talk about it in a moment. First, let's talk about the charging, which is also a great plus point on this device. In fact, the charging on this one, which is called the Super VOOC, is one of the fastest we have seen on any of the smartphone. It would charge the R17 in just 40 minutes straight, which is fastest we have seen on any Android or even any smartphone for that matter. The backup is not amazing. It lasts for about a day on average usage, and if you play games or do extensive multitasking, you'll see it may not even last for a full day. But then again, it doesn't take time to replenish the battery. So these were the good things about the Oppo R17, a great camera, great display, and a beautiful looking design, which is also quite strong. But now let's talk about what's not so good about this device, and that is the Oppo's Color OS. The Color OS is quite fast and smooth, and we did not encounter any lags or freezes on this device, but it's still the old cluttered software that we have seen on most mid-range and even budget smartphones from Oppo. So while there's no major distinguishing feature when it comes to software on the Oppo R17, out of the box, Oppo's new Color OS is still based on the older Android 8.1 platform. The price tag feels even more expensive when you compare it with phones like Nokia 8 that give the same chipset, slightly better processor, and not so bad looking design. Or maybe even the OnePlus 6T that has remained the top contender for the under 40,000 rupee budget segment gives you much better chipset and slightly better experience when it comes to software. I mean, come on, it's the fastest phone you can buy in under 40,000. What Oppo R17 gives you is a much better rear camera, charging that is faster than the OnePlus dash charging, and a lot of colors to hold in the single phone. Let us know what you think about the Oppo R17 in the comment section below. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and share it with your friends. Subscribe to our channel to get latest videos on technology, smartphones, and other gadgets like this. Thank you for watching.